All right, that buzzer only means one thing. Good evening, everybody, as we're broadcasting live here from Bishop Connolly High School in Fall River, Massachusetts. Hi, I'm David Cardelzer on the call today, and I'm here with Lucy Cabral. I'm doing the camera work as we're here at Bishop Connolly High School for this NJCAA matchup between the Bristol Community College Bayhawks and the Dean and Dean College. Bristol Bayhawks, they're coached by first-year head coach Aaron Morrell, and Dean College is led by Mr. Graham Smith. We're getting ready for the starting lineups here, and now we're just going to hold it right here while the both teams are being introduced. Coach Aaron Morrell, like I said, technically in his second season. On the first season, BCC wasn't able to field a team. Actually, we're not going to have starting lineups being here introduced. So if you're watching us on Channel 95, Comcast on your dial here on FR Media, FR Media presents NJCAA basketball between the BCC Women's Bayhawks and Dean College. Dean College in the maroon and white, and the Bristol Bayhawks. The ladies are in their green, are in their white uniforms with the green trimming. As we get set for the tip-off, with Denisha Gardner, sophomore freshman, 6'1" from Norwalk, Connecticut, and number 20, Shannon Rosenthal. Loose ball on the court. Again, it's just David Cardoza here on the call. Loose ball here in the early going. Going down the other end for BCC is number 10. And that's Shania Tarvis, freshman guard from North Providence, Rhode Island. Here comes Dean College. Number 15 on the drive, scoops it up and in. That's Caitlin Pryor, 5'6" sophomore guard from Raleigh, North Carolina. Pushing it down the court is BCC. Number 15, Misa Edwards, cross court pass in the corner, jump shot, no good, coming off. Rebounded by Dean College as number 12, Denisha Gardner. That ball dumped down inside, no good. BCC with the basketball. Losing control of it is number 10, Shania Tarvis, going back the other way. Denisha Gardner going to get fouled. Actually, they're going to call a foul on, they're going to call Denisha Gardner. Looks like it's going to be an offensive foul on her. We're tied early, 2-2. Here in period number one, we do 10-minute quarters, four 10-minute quarters here in the women's game. Must be a new rule, because as far as I've known, it's always been two 20-minute halves. Not sure exactly what the call is now. Either way, it's BCC basketball. Again, Coach Amarell coaching his first full season. His Lady Bayhawks, 1-3. They are 1-0 in Region 21 in their conference, so that's definitely a good thing. That inbound pass is intercepted by Dean, going back the other way. Nice. It's going to be a jump ball. Dean stole the inbound pass, went the other way, but there's going to be a jump ball. Good defensive play by number 30. For BCC, that's number 30, Megan Parrish. She's a freshman from Berkeley, Massachusetts. Man-to-man press. That ball in. That ball taken away. Nice pass. Nice dump off, but no good. The lay-in, no good. Going back the other way for BCC. Nice play. Number 20, Shannon Rosenthal from Sunrise, Florida, with the lay-in. Nice job by Misa Edwards to look up court. Misa Edwards from Kingshill, Virgin Islands. She's a freshman. Aaron Morrell, like I was saying before, this is technically his second year coaching the team. Last year, BCC wasn't able to field the team due to lack of participation. Coach Aaron Morrell was hired during the summer of 2015, and kind of jumped into a BCC women's program, which was in the kind of a midst of a kind of an overhaul. Kind of the midst of a an evolution, a transition. But this year, able to field, you know, girls from all over. Aaron Morrell doing a great job in recruiting. As we have a we get a foul away from the ball, it's going to be on number 10, Shane Yatarvis. So as Aaron Morrell is, he vowed to have a team in 2016, and that's exactly what he did. His team is 1-0 in the conference, 1-3 overall. Going against a good Dean team tonight here at home. Rebound, put it back up and in. Number 12, Denisha Gardner. Denisha Gardner looking to be a force here today. Early on, it's 4-4. Bayhawks hanging in there. Dean likes to play a lot of pressure defense. That ball taken away. Number 5, going the length of the court. Puts it up and can't get it to go. That was Monique Onua. In the corner for 3. It's good. Number 10, Shane Yatarvis with the trifecta. And that's going to give the home team the lead 7-4. Here in the early going from Bishop Conley, the home of the Lady and Men's Bayhawks. Driving to the hole, kicking it back out to number 15, no good. That miss was by Caitlin Pryor. Going back the other way, number 10, Shane Yatarvis gets it down inside to the center, and that ball's going to get stuck up there. Deborah Banks, sophomore from New Bedford, Massachusetts. Nice post move, just couldn't get it to go. And Morrell talking to his freshman guard, Misa Edwards. A lot of freshmen on this Bayhawk roster. You get ooh, that ball down inside to number 5 and puts it up and in. Nice post move by Fatia Larry, sophomore freshman. I mean, a sophomore forward, I'm sorry, 5'10" from Brooklyn, New York. Bounce pass, dangerous bounce pass to the top of the key. That ball is blocked by Denisha Gardner. Going back the other way with it. Driver to her left, puts it up off the glass and in. Number 2, India Pina, showing her speed. Nice drive to the hole by India Pina from Carver, Massachusetts. That's out in my backyard. Being from Wareham. Nice block by Denisha Gardner. She's becoming a force to India Pina. Looking, stutter steps to her left. Jump shot, good. Coach Aaron Morrell going to take a timeout here. Perfect time for a timeout as Dean starting to feel a little bit. Up 2, 6:03 left to play. So as I was saying, Aaron Morrell obviously doing a good job with this lady program, getting it together. Aaron Morrell doing a great job going all over to recruit a girl like Deisha Eason, guard from Chicago, Illinois, freshman. You know, he got, you know, like I said, Misa Edwards, number 15, a freshman from Kings Hill, Virgin Islands. And then Shannon Rosensteel from Sunrise, Florida. Adia Contractor, number 33, who's a freshman forward from Miami, Florida. So obviously, Aaron Morrell has great roots down there in Florida, doing a good job recruiting. And also roots in the Midwest, as he's coached for Milwaukee Tech for the women's team out there. Did a great job with them. And, you know, obviously, Deisha Eason being from Chicago, Illinois. And, Aaron Morrell putting his stamp on this Lady Bayhawks program. So it's good to see Bayhawks, Lady Bayhawks basketball back here in 2016. Aaron Morrell looking to do great things. You know, it's not going to be, it's not going to be top-notch overnight. Rome wasn't built in a day, but Aaron Morrell definitely the guy to, bring this Bayhawks team back up and, you know, playing in postseason basketball. Number 30, driver to the hole, gets it blocked by number 5. Back to you, Larry. Megan Parrish having her shot blocked. Good dribble drive, but now we have a loose ball on the floor. That looks to be a loose ball foul. Now there's a little confusion. I'm not sure what's going on. All I know is Lady Bayhawks basketball right now. Bayhawks looking inbound. That's Megan Parrish. Freshman guard for Berkeley, Mass. Oh, kicks it back out. Corner three again. This time it's an air ball. I thought that went off Megan Parrish, but it was looked like it went off number 15 now. That's Caitlin Pryor. Parrish to inbound. Kicks it back out. That's number 24. It's Tatiana Ramos. Tarvis from three. Gets it to go. Puts on the line, they're going to say. But still, nice shot. Showing some great touch early on to Shenya Tarvis, freshman from North Providence. Nice shot there. Going down low. Denisha Gardner to the right, to her right. She's going to get the foul and go into the line. Foul's going to be on Deborah Banks, number 31. Foul's going to be on her. Nice post move. Denisha Gardner doing a tremendous job in the early going. Can't get the first one to go. 5:18 left in the play in the first quarter. Gardner, the second one is good. Dean always putting pressure on, playing man-to-man, or woman-to-woman. All the way up the court. Nice drive there. Nice drive there. Strong move by Tatiana Ramos going through the middle of the lane, putting it out the window, and sinks it to go. 11-11. Competitive contest early going. Denisha Gardner, the top of the key. Looking to drive. Puts it up, and she's going to the line again. Denisha Gardner definitely knows how to take the ball to the rack and gain the contact. Looks like she could be doing that all day. Again, Denisha Gardner stands at 6'1". She's from Norwalk, Connecticut. Went to Colby Cathedral. Nice touch at the free throw line, too, there. She nails the first one. Second one is good. Both free throws are A-OK. Here comes the pressure up court. Cheyenne Tarvis going to lose it. Lose it to number 15. Caitlin Pryor going the other way. Going to put it up off the glass and in. Bayhawks definitely going to have to earn their keep today, trying to get through this Dean pressure. Ooh, it looked like that was going to be steps there by Cheyenne Tarvis. Cheyenne Tarvis looked like she might have got fouled. Not going to get the call, though. Dean comes away with the basketball. Dean definitely looks like a well-oiled machine. Going to her right, kicking back out was number 11, Chelsea Johnson. Johnson ends up back with it. Cross-court pass. Number two for three. No good. That shot was by India Pina, who couldn't get it to go. Here comes Megan Parrish for the Bayhawks. Al Morrell calling the play, Bayhawk. Driving to her left. Wild shot, couldn't get it to go. Here's Shania Tarvis, looking baseline. She stepped out of bounds. Actually, no. The call is going to be a foul. They're going to call a foul on Chelsea Johnson, sophomore guard, 5'6", Albany from Albany, New York. Megan Parrish to inbound, gets it to Shania Tarvis, swinging it. It's going to end up down low, driving to her right. Can't get it to go. It's going to be Dean basketball. So that ball is just out of bounds. Tatiana Ramos couldn't get it to fall. Thought she might have gained contact, but she did not. Here's Chelsea Johnson looking to get it inside. Nice defense there by number 31, Deborah Banks, to deny. Oh, and the Bayhawks force Dean to go out of bounds. Bayhawks basketball, 15-11. Bayhawks hanging in this one. Talked to Coach Al Morrell earlier before the game. Said that Dean is definitely a good basketball team. Going the other way, the steal. Number five, no good. India Pina trying to put it up. Can't get that to fall. Dean with the offensive rebound. That's number five, Fatia Larry. Looks like she got fouled. Not sure she got fouled on the on the floor or if she got fouled in the act of shooting. Either way, it's going to stay here, team basketball. Again, if you're just joining us, we're here at Bishop Connolly High School here in Fall River, Massachusetts. Inbound pass to India Pena, and it's good. India Pena from the corner with a short jumper, making it 17-11, Dean. That ball is going to go out of bounds, sails out of bounds. Shania Tarvis throwing that one over Megan Parishhead. Turnovers. Turnovers will kill you, especially when you're playing a team against Dean, who seems to be, pretty good defensive team. You know, pressuring the Bayhawks every chance they can get. Number 11 crossing over, Chelsea Johnson. Looks like she's going to get fouled in the act of shooting. That foul is going to be on number 30, Megan Parrish. That's going to be her first foul. First free throw is going to be missed. Chelsea Johnson misses the first one. We have substitutions. Number 32 coming in. Kedra Castro. Kedra Castro, number 32, coming in for Dean. Here's Megan Parrish, going to settle for the jumper. Air ball, can't get it to go. Here comes Dean. That was Denisha Gardner with the rebound. Here's number 5, landed up and in. Fatia Lowry. And this is where Dean's at their best. After a make basket, they want to get in the passing lanes. They want to disrupt the Bayhawks. They want to pressure them up the court. Not exactly sure if the Bayhawks have the ball handlers to try to get through this disruptive force of Dean defense that they're displaying. Ooh, there's good ball movement there. Putting up the putback is good. After a missed shot by Megan Parrish, number 24, Tatiana Ramos with the putback. Good job to get there on the offensive boards. Denisha Gardner driving to her right, kicks back out. Jump shot, no good. Rebounded by Gardner, can't get it to go. Gets a rebound again, and she'll get fouled. That foul is going to be on Misa Edwards. Looks to be her first foul. And Denisha Gardner will step up to the line again for some more free throws. 20-13. Dean leads with a minute 38 left here in the first quarter. That first free throw no good. Number 33 is going to come in. Adia Contractor will come in for Deborah Banks. AD Contractor is a freshman forward from Miami, Florida. And that shot there is sunk by Gardner. Here comes the press. Megan Parrish driving to her right. Puts it above the glass. Can't get it to go. Rebounded by Gardner. Gardner grabbing all the rebounds for Dean. Oh, nice pass inside there to number 5. Nice play. Nice pass there by India Pena finding her forward. Sophomore forward, Fatia Lowry underneath. What a nice pass. Good look. Good basketball there. And Dean's going to find themselves back with the basketball. Turnover by the Bayhawks. Dean will get the ball right back. India Pena for 3 off the inbound. Bounces up, no good. Rebounded by number 24, Tatio Ramos. Driving to the hole. Strong move. Looking to make a strong move was Misa Edwards, driving strong to her right. And looks like we get a foul on number 32, and it's going to be Kyra Castro. Inbound pass, getting into Ramos. She got blocked, but looks like there's going to be another foul. That's 4 team fouls on the guest, Dean College. 5 team fouls on the home team, the Bayhawks. Both teams not in the bonus yet. Inbound pass to number 20. No good. I'm not sure. That ball goes out of bounds. I'm not sure what ADA contractor. I'm not sure what she was thinking. She went a little laissez-faire over to that basketball. Watch it go out of bounds. I'm not sure she thought that if it hit a Dean player, but nonetheless, Dean has the basketball here with 50 seconds to play in the first quarter. India Pena. Jump shot from the top. Number five, Fatia Lowry banks it in. Not sure she called glass, but either way, it counts on the scoreboard. That's the way to move the ball past this press. Good ball movement there. Bangin' Parrish, nice. Oh, try to get a bounce pass in there to Ramos. Couldn't get it. Going back the other way is India Pena. No good. Rebounded by Lowry. Puts it about the glass. No good. Dean all over the offensive boards. Bayhawks need to do a better job boxing out. Stop giving Dean second and third opportunities. And not only that, need to stop sending Dean to the free throw line. Because that's where they're going right now. Chelsea Johnson, the sophomore guard, stepping up to the line. Can't get the first one to go. Number 10 will check in for the Bayhawks. That's number 10, Chania Tarvis. Megan Parrish will step out. 24 seconds left to play in the first quarter. And that second free throw will go in for Chelsea Johnson. Dean, here comes that half-court trap. Bayhawks able to get past it, though. Nice block there by Lowry as she blocks Missa Edwards. Going back the other way to India Pena. Puts it up the glass, left hand, good. Dean starting to separate themselves now. That ball swatted by Pena. Dean starting to play immense basketball. All right, at the end of the first quarter, ladies and gentlemen, here on FR Media, 27-13, Dean College leading this one over the Lady Bayhawks. All right, so the Bayhawks only with 13 points. They were staying in this one for a little bit. You know, it was a close game. Bayhawks actually had the lead here in the early going, but Dean has been able to assert themselves with some very good defensive play. They've been pressing the Bayhawks up the court, you know, and trapping at half court after made baskets, and they've been able to cause a lot of Lady Bayhawks turnovers. Also, the Bayhawks not being able to really be any kind of a force on the boards. The Dean College, their ladies have been able to get on the boards, create second and third opportunities for themselves, whether it results in a made basket or sends them to the free throw line. That's been the difference. Bayhawks, you know, not able to do anything too much offensively, not able to get in a groove into their offense. The ball movement's been kind of lackluster. Hopefully that improves here in the second half, in the second quarter. And also, speaking of the Bayhawks soccer team in New York for the national tournament, the Bayhawks have had a tremendous season, an exciting season, winning Region 21, you know, advancing to the national tournament in New York. There was a loss today, but that doesn't count them out of it as they're still in it. It is double elimination, so we wish our soccer team, our Bayhawks, well. The athletic director, Derek Riveros, he's not here today, but he is in New York watching the Bayhawks soccer team, so good luck to the Bayhawks. Lucy Cabral taking selfies of us over here. Selfie Nation, putting that on the Bristol Bayhawks page, I'm sure. FR Media. All right, getting ready for the second quarter. Hopefully the Bayhawks can make a little bit of a charge here, as it's only David Cardoza on the call, but it's also Lucy Cabral. It's a Cardoza and Cabral combination. So good job on the camera work. Lucy, keep up the good job. We just came from the TV studio recording the Dirty Water Sports Hour. So also on this network, on the FR Media Network over here, you can watch the Dirty Water Sports Hour. Look out for that on your local listings. In the corner, that shot is no good. Chenya Taurus with the air ball. Going back the other way. Open is Larry. Good. Nice pass there. Nice pass to find the open lady there. That was number two, India Pina. Those two have been tearing it up. That's going to be a backcourt. Can't go over then back. Over then back. Dean basketball, 29-13. Again, you know, the Bayhawks, they do have a win on the young season. And an important win at that. They won their first game in Region 21, which overall is, I mean, that's the conference. India Pina, jump shot from the top of the key, drains it. India Pina, 5'6". 5'6", sophomore guard from Carver, Massachusetts. That ball picked off. Number 10, lays it up and in. That's Jamelia Schultz. Jamelia Schultz getting in the action, the freshman guard from Bristol, Connecticut. And just like that, it's a 20-point lead. As I was saying earlier, for this Lady Bayhawk program, it's all about growth and it's all about baby steps. The fact that they have a team, 9 or 10 girls now, but there's been a couple injuries, so I mean, there's been at least 12 or 13 girls on this team to start. Here's number 5, Fatia Lowry in the lane. That pass was by Denisha Gardner finding Larry. Larry has been. How many points for Larry? The story of the game has been Fatia Lowry, the sophomore forward, and also India Pina and Denisha Gardner, who's been immense down low for Dean. Driving to a left is India. It's going to be a travel call. Going to be a travel call on Jamelia Schultz. A little too quick for her own good as she tried driving to her left. And then she's going to be called for travel. Here comes that trap. Here comes that press. You got to get through it. You got to beat that press with some ball movement. And there's another loose ball. Number 11, Chelsea Johnston, going all the way to the rack. Can't get it to go. Putback is good. Putback is by India Pina. Sneaking in there. Sneaky good. 37-13. That ball intercepted. That pass. And that's going to be rolled home by Jamia Schultz. All of a sudden, she's come out of the woodwork. Dean coming over from the Boston area, coming up here to Fall River, Massachusetts. Dean not in the conference. They're not in Region 21 with the Lady Bayhawks. This is a non-conference game. It's a non-conference game for Aaron Morrell's Lady Bayhawks. Can't get enough of those. They're facing some stiff competition in a couple weeks. They're going to be facing the Naval Prep School. That should definitely be a challenge. You know, you schedule a lot of these non-conference games against some stiff competition. It's going to help you when it counts down the stretch, and in the region. You know, so. Coach Amarell definitely knows what he's doing. Let's get some points here for Fatia Lowry. How many points does Fatia Lowry have? Statistician. Stat girl. Little stat girl. Fatia Lowry. How many points does she have? 10? Seems like she has 20. How about India Pina? 14. Okay. India Pina, 14 points. You heard it here. Thank you, little stat girl. 14 points for India Pina and 10 points for Fatia Lowry. Those guys catapulting Dean right now. And also Denisha Gardner has been a force down inside with her play. We'll have some halftime stats for you here on FR Media. Again, it's not just a one-man show. Yeah, Lucy Cabral over here and little stat girl. Here come the Bayhawks. Bayhawks going to get the ball into their playmakers, into their ball handlers. Got to make a little run. You're going to get blown out of your own gym. That ball cross court to Megan Parrish. Should have put that jump shot up there. Spinning in the lane. That's Misa Edwards. Definitely think you're definitely going to get the ball into your ball handlers like a Shania Tarvis, Misa Edwards. That's your freshman backcourt. again, those two young. It's young in the season. These guys, these girls playing their first college basketball games, but they're very, very early in their career. That first free throw was good. Second free throw was good. Definitely like the spunk that Misa Edwards brings to the table. Both free throws made. That's India Pina for three. Bounces out, no good. Tipped up. Again, all over the offensive boards is Dean. They're going to try to get it inside. That's Lowry. Nice. Oh, my goodness. Nice post move. Nice drop step. Puts it above the glass. Lowry going into the post, showing her post moves now. Parrish. Cross-court pass. Shania Tarvis. Ramos being guarded closely by Lowry. Puts up fall away. No good. That was rebounded by Nisha Gardner. Another rebound for her. Oh, nice ball movement there. They get it inside to Gardner. She's going to go back to the free throw line. to 15. 7:07 left to play. A lot of time left. All right, first free throw missed. Still hope here for the Bayhawks. Second free throw. Stranger things have happened, right? 42-16. Got to start making a run at it now, though. Here comes that trap by Dean. Over the timeline we go. Here comes Parrish. Puts it up. No good. In there for the rebound. And I think she's going to get a foul. Deborah Banks, good job. Good job getting in the mix, getting the rebound off of Parrish's miss. And she's going to go to the line for two. Bayhawks just need to be aggressive. They need to be aggressive, you know, against this, athletic, dynamic team like Dean. They can't be scared. They got to take it right to them. Dean has a lot of athletes on their team, but, you know, got to get in there and mix it up and take your chances. Bayhawks don't have any slouches. I mean, they don't have, slouches on this team. Second free throw was good by Deborah Banks. Here's India Pina. Boy, she's a spark. Kicks it back out for three. Chelsea Johnson, no good. Rebounded by Denisha Gardner. Gets her own rebound again, and she's going to go back to the free throw line. That's where she's living these days. At the line, at the charity stripe. And that's the story. Denisha Gardner able to get any kind of shot she wants. Not always making it every single time, but getting to the free throw line. And number 33 checks in, Adia Contractor. She's going to come in for number 24, Tatio Ramos. Gardner's second free throw, no good. Rebounded by Banks. Parrish holds up her dribble, gets it to Misa Edwards. Dean likes to play man-to-man. Loose ball on the floor. Nice hustle there by number 31, Deborah Banks. Looks like it's going to stay. No, it's going to be Dean basketball. They get the possession arrow. All right, India Pina to dribble the ball up for the for Dean College. Inside, Gardner kicks it back out. And that's number five there. Lowry for the jumper from the top of the key. I mean, from the free throw line. More points for her. Again, Dean. Steps. This is what they do. Causing turnovers, causing havoc with that press. With that pressing defense and that half-court trap. Dean able to do whatever they want to do, whatever they want to get. They're going to get the ball back on when they're on defense. That's the goal. They're looking to turn the ball. They're looking to make you screw up, turn the ball over. Loose ball coming away with it. Parrish going all the way to the hole. Nice drive. Best play all night, I think, with the Bayhawks. Fearless. Good job, Megan Parrish. A freshman getting the steal and taking it the length of the court. Lays it up and in. Something like that can light a fire. Got to play D in the lane. Larry's getting whatever she wants to get. Goodness gracious, someone's going to stop that. Do we have a technical foul? All right, so the basket counts on that end again. Again, Fatia Larry, the sophomore forward. I mean, this has been her game. She's been able to get so many good looks underneath the basket. Not just underneath the basket, but jump shots, anything. She's been getting open looks. This has been her game. So referee talking to both coaches, Graham Smith and also Mr. Aram Morrell. So I'm not sure. I think there's been words maybe said by both teams. Not really sure what's going on here. Thought there might have been a technical at first. Either way, the Bayhawks are going to get the basketball. Dean already matching up. Already matching up against the Bayhawks. Looking to put that pressure on. It seems like every time the Bayhawks have the basketball, when they're bringing the basketball up the length of the court, Dean is at least putting a hand on it every single time. If they're not turning the ball over, I mean, if they're not getting the steal, they're at least putting their hand on it at some point. Loose ball. Yeah, that foul's on number 10. Refs did number 13, but that's not the case. There is no number 13 on Dean. That foul's going to be on number 10, I believe, Jamelia Schultz. 5:02 left to play here in the first half. Misa Edwards at the basketball. Coach Morrell calling out the play. Here's Parrish. I'd like to see her take some more shots. Getting trapped in the corner is Parrish. Going to get it to the open girl. Going to be another. Going to be 3 seconds. Going to be offensive 3 seconds. Not sure who that was on. That's the call. It's going back Dean's way. 46-18. If you're just joining us, you're watching Lady Bayhawks basketball, Bristol Community College basketball here on FR Media. Number 4 is checking to the game. That's Jennifer Lang. Coach Smith going to his bench. They're going to get it down low. And that is going to be a jump ball. This is probably going to be Bayhawks' ball. It is going to be. Going to be possession arrow in the Bayhawks' favor. Bayhawks trying to end this first half on a high note. Again, Dean is just relentless. They are always man-to-man or woman-to-woman. Bayhawks in press-breaking mode here. Trying to get it over half court. That's been a challenge. Misa Edwards driving to her right on Lang. Kicks it back out. Here we go. And it's going to be steps. They pass it to Banks at the top of the key, looking to drive to her right. And she's going to be called for a travel. So we're right back to Dean it goes. Bayhawks have failed to get any kind of momentum here in the first half, since the beginning of the first half. Driving to her left is India Pina. Jennifer Lang for three. Air ball, rebounded by Parrish. Here's Tarvis over to Misa Edwards. And she stepped out of bounds. And it's going to go right back in Dean College's direction.
Deuce. Patience. Deuce. Patience. Go, Farrah.
Here's Lang looking inside. Number 23, nice post move, but a bad shot, rebounded by Parrish. That shot was by Kia Pate, 5'9" forward from Taunton. Here's Tarvis. Over to Edwards. That's her shot right there. Three-pointer, no good. Good look, though. Tarvis in the lane. Gets it to go. Good offensive rebound by Tarvis. Drives the lane and puts it up and in. Good job there. Timeout on the floor. Timeout's going to be on red. Timeout's going to be on Dean College. Good job, Lucy. Oh, I don't think any cameraman or camerawoman has gotten more credit than Lucy so far. When did they ever say the camerawoman's name on the air? Goodness gracious. So 46-20 is just David Cardoza here on the call. And, again, if you're, you watch it for media, look out for the Dirty Water Sports Hour, which is in syndication, you can find in your local listings. Also, listen to us on Thursdays. It's the Dirty Water Sports Hour podcast as we talk to you about all the latest in Boston pro sports, or all sport. All sports really. And listen to us on bccradio.org on Thursday evenings at 6:30 p.m. Go to bccradio.org and download the TuneIn Radio app. Put in the search engine. BCC Radio, and you'll find the Dirty Water Sports Hour. That's every Thursday. We record the show at 5 o'clock. The show comes on at 6:30 on bccradio.org. But also we double dip because it's a television show as well. So look for us here on your Comcast dial. Look for the Dirty Water Sports Hour. It's with Cardoza and Andrews. So Coach Aaron Morell trying to rally the troops here. Scores 46-20. Bayhawks looking to go on at least a little mini run. You know, go into the locker room feeling semi-good about yourself, you know. Here's Jennifer Lang with the basketball, number 4, driving to her right. Looking to dump it inside. Deflected by Misa Edwards from the Bayhawks, number 15. And it's going to stay here, Dean basketball. And if you're just joining us, obviously Bristol Community College is in white with green trimming. Dean in red or maroon. Inbound pass, will dump it in to number 23. Pate turns around, puts it in. Doing a little spin is number 23, Key Pate. Dean, they don't rest. They don't rest on defense. Nice bounce pass by Parrish. Good job. Going to be a travel, though. Shannon Rosensteel. Got a nice feed from Parrish. I like to see her do more with the basketball. I think she's got some skill. I like to see her shoot more, handle the ball more. Jennifer Lang. That ball deflected, but gets it inside to Pate. Puts it up off the glass. Puts it up and in. Nice strong move. Kia Pate off the bench. The freshman getting some burn. Couple baskets for her the last couple times down the court. Here's Tarvis. Makes it. At the top of the key, number 20, Shannon Rosensteel. Here's Parrish, looking to drive. Cross-court pass. Nice little move there. And the foul call. Nice pass by Parrish to create and get the ball to number 20, Rosensteel, who had a nice little fake there, drove it to the hole, and laid it up for two. Number 31, Deborah Banks coming in for 80 a contractor. These two look like sisters over here. Going in and out for each other. Bayhawks do got some height and some size. Should be able to do a lot more with that. We'll see as they grow as a team. That free throw made there, the old-fashioned three-point play. And drivers to the hole, Jennifer Lang with her first bucket. Everybody getting in on the act for Dean. Going back the other way, Rosensteel, putting up at the glass, no good, can't get it to go. Had an opportunity there. Dean with the rebound. Here's Caitlin Pryor, up to number 21 for three, wide of the mark. That's Amanda Maresi just checking into the game. She's a sophomore. Sophomore guard, 5'6", from New Rochelle, New York. went to Sacred Heart High School. So number 21, Amanda Moresti, she's in there for Dean. Also number 15, Caitlin Pryor. Jennifer Lang, number 4. Number 25 now in there for Dean. Kia Pate. Another opportunity for Rosa Steele. Two baskets, two opportunities, two shots there. Offensive rebounds. Maybe they need to get it inside to her. Let her create some offense. It's going to be Dean basketball. They're going to call over the back. That call is going to be on number 20, Shannon Rodensteel, when she went up for the offensive board, when she went up for the rebound. She caused a little contact there with a Dean player. Here's Jennifer Lang. Jennifer Lang looking like a little mighty mite. Fearless going to the hole. Can't get it to go. Parrish with the rebound for Bayhawks. Nice pass up all the way up the court, out the glass and in to number 20, Shannon Rodensteel. That's going to be a little duo right there. 52-25. Parrish playing well. Rodensteel too. Lang picks up her dribble. They'll swing it into the corner. Down low, number 25 can't get it to go. Rebound Rodensteel. Here we go. Bayhawks looking to get in transition. Shanye Tarvis driving to her right. Puts it up. No good. Rebound and a foul. Good job. Now the Bayhawks showing some continuity. They can if they can just play some defense and stop Dean from getting so many makes, Dean won't be able to get into their press. They won't be able to press the Lady Bayhawks all the way up the court 24-7. Bayhawks need to get out there and run and get in transition. They're not doing so good at the half court game. Deborah Banks upset with herself as the Bayhawks making a little hay. Playing well here in the last couple minutes. I want to try to keep the momentum. Shot made. All right. Deborah Banks, 52-26. I'm sorry, 52-25. 6 second differential between the shot clock and the game clock. 25 seconds left, 17 on the shot clock. Dean's so patient with the basketball, though. Get it down. Kia Pate off the glass and in. Boy, has she done a great job off the bench for Dean. 10 on the game clock. Here's Shania Tarvis. Bayhawks looking to get a good look. That ball almost knocked away. Misa Edwards going to put it up for three. No good as the buzzer sounds off. So the Bayhawks were trying to get back into this one. Good effort, though. Good effort by the Lady Bayhawks. Seemingly outmatched now by Dean, who has got a deep team. They got a bunch of girls that are definitely in the scoring column, and almost every player has played for Dean. So anyways, here at the end of the first half, we're going to take a step away. It's 54-25. In action, Dean College with the lead, 54-25, as we're back underway here in the second half. Going back the other way is India Pina. India Pina is going to encounter Misa Edwards, but it doesn't matter. She puts it up and in. All right, so Misa Edwards is going to commit the foul. Misa Edwards was kind of on an island. She had India Pina going right for her, making a beeline. India Pina with a sweet move. And she's going to put that one up and look for the three-point play. 56-25, 9:33 to play. We're just underway here in the second half if you're just joining us. There's going to be a lane violation. It looks like it's going to be on the Bayhawks. Get into the lane too quick, and they're going to call it a number 31, Deborah Banks. So India Pina will get another shot at this three-point play. Pina. And she'll capitalize. And she pumps her fist like, yeah. She got that one, 57-25. Here comes Bristol Community College. Here's Edwards. Parrish driving to her right. Puts it up and can't get it to go. Good drive, though. Good look.
Indiapina, 2-on-1. Nice pass to Larry. Can't get it to go. Rebounded by Tarvis. Tarvis doesn't have the numbers, but she'll get fouled by Pina with a reach-in. All right, I'm David Cadoza on the call here with Lucy Cabral and the little stat girl. 9-11. What do you do in a game like this? We'll see if Bayhawks can make a comeback. That ball knocked away by Denisha Gardner. Denisha Gardner, number 12, has been a force to be reckoned with inside for Dean. Ooh. Bayhawks going to turn the ball over. That ball goes out of bounds. Rosensteel pass. Shania Tarvis couldn't hold on to it. Do we have a nickname for the for Dean College? Yeah. What do you say, we'll go with it. We'll go with the Bulldogs. Do you go to Dean?
Yes, I go.
Okay. You got to find that out. We'll say, if you're telling me it's Bulldogs, then it's Bulldogs. Dean looking in the bottom of the ball. Underneath their own basket. Nice pass to Denisha Gardner. Driving to the hole. Nice pass by Indiapina. These two girls lighting it up together. Nice little inbound play. Indiapina noticing Gardner driving to the hole. Gardner got the position. Was able to score it. Counting and it's good. Dean really starting to open up this lead as we here in the early going near the second half. 59-25, looking to make it 60, and she does it. Nice touch from the free throw line by Miss Gardner. Here come the Bayhawks, looking to generate some offense. Megan Parrish, that ball's gonna be intercepted by Gardner. Gardner looking to take it to the hole. No good, but she gets her own rebound. Pina. Looks like there's a foul there. Foul's going to be away from the basketball. Shania Tarvis apparently with a push off. And it looks like it's going to be a technical foul. Shania Tarvis with some words. And Amarell's going to have a little talking to with Shania Tarvis because she's not in a good place right now. So looks like she's going to come out of the game, being replaced by Shannon Rosensteel. Rosensteel from Sunrise, Florida. Sounds like a place I want to visit right now. Sunrise, Florida. Lucy Cabral, the thumbs up. All right.
10-4.
What to do? All right, shooting the technical foul shot is number 11, Chelsea Johnson, sophomore from Albany, New York. She's going to get two of them. The second one is good. Dean has done a good job of coming in here to Bishop Conley into BCC's home court, silencing this crowd, and really playing a great all-around basketball game. So, again, the Bayhawks, they're looking to have some building blocks. Driving to a left is Rosensteel. And it's going to be some steps there. Not as many steps as the men's game the other night, though. Men's game featured a lot of traveling. And I do mean a lot. A lot more than this game. All right, here's Indiapina. Walking the ball up the court. No stress here. Not sure if there's a violation or just a timeout on the court for clock purposes right now. Either way, it's going to be Dean basketball inbounded from the sideline, the right sideline over here. Number 15. Caitlin Pryor to inbound the basketball. Caitlin Pryor from Raleigh. North Carolina. India Pina with the basketball, going to set up for the jumper. No good. Had a good look there. Rebounded by Rosensteel. Had that ball deflected by India Pina and others. Probably Caitlin Pryor got a hand on that one, too. Dean has relaxed on that press with a huge lead now. Here's Misa Edwards. Bayhawks need to show some urgency. Edwards only driving to her right. Loose ball on the floor. Nice hustle by India Pina. Gotta love her hustle. Nice pass by Gardner. Up to Larry. Lays it up and in. Gardner could do it all. Nice look up the court to Larry. Fatia Larry. Dean doing a great job. Pick set. Now driving to the hole. Edwards. That ball deflected by Gardner. India Pina with the loose ball. Gets it to Chelsea Johnson. Johnson putting it up. No good. Rebounded by Gardner. No good. Loose ball. Megan Parrish. Here comes Megan Parrish. Parrish driving to her left. Puts it up. And it's going to be a blocking foul. Nice play to get over there was Denisha Gardner trying to get the charge call. Feet weren't set, apparently. But Megan Parrish, a nice aggressive move, will step to the free throw line. Like I said, I like to see her be more aggressive on the offensive end. She looks like she can go with her right or left. She's had a few good plays, a couple good assists there for the Bayhawks. And she'll sink the second one. Looks like she got a little good little stroke there too, so. On the court now for the Bayhawks, number 33, 80 contractor, number 20, Shenya Rosensteel, Megan Parrish. Number 30. India Pina driving to her right, stops at the corner. That's the air ball. Rebounded by number 20, Rosensteel. Pushing it for the Bayhawks is Edwards. They'll jump it in. Number 31 gets it blocked. That block was by number 5, Fatia Larry, I believe. India Pina driving the length of the court and gets it knocked out of bounds. 5:55 left to play here in the third quarter. Again, we play four quarters here. Here in the women's game, at least this women's game. All right. Gotta love the crisp passing by Dean and the movement. Driving, kicking it back out. Loose ball. Larry loses it. Pina gains it. But it's going to be steps. Steps is going to be on Fatia Larry. All right, walking the basketball up right now. Misa Edwards again. I know you're down by nearly 40 points, but you got to show some sense of urgency. You got to push the ball up the court. You got to attack them. Rosensteel going to get a foul. The foul call is going to be on number 15. That's Caitlin Pryor. Foul's going to be on the floor. 14 foul by the guest, Dean College Bulldogs. Okay, so the Bayhawks will inbound underneath their own basket. Dean matching up man-to-man, woman-to-woman. Nice hustle play by India Pina. Knocked that inbound pass out of bounds. That girl's been all over the place. Megan Parrish kicks it out. That's number 24, Tatiana Ramos. Here's Edwards. Trying to get that ball in. Inside. Couldn't do it. Here's Pina on the lay-in. Good. Score it. How many for Pina? Loose ball on the floor. India Pina. Sorry, Lindia Pina. I must be blind. Oh, is it India? Oh, it is India. So I've been saying it the right time. I've been saying it right the whole time. All right. India Pina. That sounds better. India Pina has 19 points. Here she is again. Trying to get inside to Fatia Larry. Does. Huh? Oh, Fatia. Okay. Fatia. Just call her Larry, like bird. Taya? Oh, just Tay. All right, from the elbow, Tay. Fatia with the miss there, but looks like it's going in the Bayhawks' direction. Okay, so it's not Fatia Larry. It's Fatia Larry. So my bad on that one. Fatia Larry been doing a great job for Dean as well as India Pina. Those two, and, I mean, Denisha Gardner, the list goes on and on. Everybody's been playing well for that team. Deep team. That shot made. Shot made by Shannon Rosensteel. Rosensteel, Sunrise, Florida native, hits both free throws. Quietly having a decent game is Miss Steele. It can only go up from here. Get some games underneath her belt. Her game should blossom. Offense. It's going to be an offensive foul. It's going to be on Fatia. Fatia Larry leading with the shoulder. Offensive foul on her. 66-28. Coming up on 4 minutes left to play in the first half. In the third quarter. Misa Edwards being pressured, being double teamed, somehow gets out of trouble. Now driving to the right, all the way to the basket. Couldn't finish the deal, though. Nice effort on her part to get out of that double team. Take it to the basket. Couldn't connect, though. And it looks like it's going to stay right here. So apparently that basketball, the ball is off of Dean. In the corner, Parrish has a wide open Edwards. Edwards for three. Oh, so close. Just bounced out, rattled out. Couldn't get it to go. Had a good look. It's going to stay Lady Bayhawks basketball here, though. Megan Parrish to inbound for the Bayhawks. Number 10 coming in for number 15. That's number 10. Jamelia Schultz coming in for Caitlin Pryor. All right, another push off by Dean. Dean likes to do that, huh? That's number 32, Kiara Castro from Howard Beach, New York. Went to Queens Metropolitan High School. She's charged with the foul. Rosensteel to the line, makes the first free throw. I'm sorry, Tatiana Ramos. Good dose of foul shooting, good. Ramos, both free throws made. Driving to her left, all the way, puts it up with the right, no good, but a good drive. Good take there by number 10, Jamelia Schultz. We got players from all over for both teams. Chicago representative, obviously Massachusetts and Rhode Island, but Florida and even Seattle. Right, Tara Griffith for the freshman center, 6'2", who we haven't seen yet, is from Seattle, Washington, went to Oak Hill High School out there. Also North Carolina, Connecticut. So all these girls making their way down here to southeastern Massachusetts playing college basketball. NJCAA action. You're watching it here on FR Media. Channel 95 on your dial. You're in the local Fall River and surrounding areas. Hope you're enjoying this game. It's only November. A lot of basketball left to be played. Number 11 for three, no good. Chelsea Johnson with the miss coming off. No one touched it, so it's going to be Bayhawks basketball. 67 to 30, 3:50 left to play here in the third quarter. Here's Edwards. All right, driving to the basket is Rodensteel. No good. Coming back is Fatea Larry. Takes it all the way to the hole. Parrish getting out of the way. Guess she really didn't have a choice. 69 to 30. Fatea Larry with a big game on her. Looks like there's going to be a foul. And looks like Ramos, Tatiana Ramos, looks like she's going to step to the line again. That foul is going to be on number 23. Another girl that we haven't seen too much is Farah Beattie, 6 foot, sophomore forward from Windsor, Connecticut. All right, that second free throw, no, both free throws, no good. Five team fouls for Dean, 4 team fouls for the host Bayhawks. Well, both teams not really in foul trouble yet. Oh, at the top of the key, nice pass. Faking the shot, but finding a cutting Rosensteel. Cut into the basket, I'm sorry, Ramos. That was a nice play by Misa Edwards. Good look. Love the way she faked it, like she was going to take a shot, but really found the cutting Ramos. Tossing it around the perimeter. There's a shot there by Beattie. Farah Beattie with the jumper in the corner. Giving Dean their 71st points. All right, that's a push off. Driving to the hole is Rodensteel, but she pushed off with her forearm as she was driving. So it's going to be back on the other way. At the top of the key, Fatea Larry looking to drive, kicks it back out to Castro. Castro looking to put it up, no good. Okay, that foul is going to be on Jamelia Schultz. Oh, that foul away from the basketball. Okay, and I'm forgetting we're playing quarters now. So 5 team fouls, we'll put each team in the bonus now. And that free throw was good. Both teams will be taking 2 shots from here on out in the third quarter. Second free throw, no good. Ramos stepping her game up now. Here's Kiara Castro. Jamelia Schultz driving into the lane all around the world. Puts it up off the glass and in. Jamelia Schultz. 73 to 33, 40-point lead now. What was looking to be a promising, result here in the early going. The Bayhawks had it going early on. They had a 7-4 lead. I mean, it was tied at 11-11. They had a couple ties, 11-11, 13-13. It was pretty close here in the early going, and then Dean was able to pull away with their. With their pressing action, with their half-court trap, with their defense, with their energy, and also with their deepness of their team, and everybody having an ability to chip in. So Coach Graham Smith has to be very, very pleased with his ladies today, as everybody has come in and contributed for the most part, and in a big way. They really backed off with the press here in the third quarter, but it, for 20 minutes straight. I mean, after every made basket, Dean was relentless. Getting inside to Ramos, puts it up the glass and in. Nice pass by Parrish. Nice entry pass by Parrish. That was Tatiana Ramos, freshman from Pawtucket, Rhode Island, went to Central Falls High School in Rhode Island. Number 21, Amanda Moresi. They're going to dump it inside of Fatea Lowry, and they're going to call a foul there on Deborah Banks. Deborah Banks, that's her second foul. That's a miss there. I mean, a rare miss on the day for Fatea Lowry. Fatea Lowry, they like to call her Tay. Tay with the second one's good. Driving to the hole, losing it, but I believe there's a foul that could be on Tay. It's going to be on number 32, Kiara Castro. Front rimming that is Rosensteel. Shannon Rosensteel at the line. Both free throws missed. Rebounded by Castro. Looking to push it up the other way. Being guarded by Edwards. We get a new group out here for Dean. Minus Fatea. That ball deflected. Tipped up, tapped away, and that's going to be the end of the third quarter. All right, so here at Bishop Connolly High School at the end of three, 74-35. The Dean College Bulldogs over the Bayhawks right now as we enter the last quarter. All right, so Dean has really, really played a complete game here. They've really come to play. I mean, really, after the first, after the first quarter, it's really been all Dean. Dean has been in control. So for India Pina, I mean, she has been an unbelievable spark plug for them. I mean, she's like the engine that makes this Bulldogs team go. She has 20 points. And again, Fatea Lowry has been huge too. She has 20 as well. So those two have been two really big engines for the Lady Bulldogs. Also Denisha Gardner. I mean, how big has she been? Yep. Yeah, Denisha Gardner has been a force inside as well for BCC. Tatiana Ramos and Shannon Rosensteel have really been two big cogs for them. So, Parrish, got to come to the basketball. Got to come help her out. Got to see more ball movement if you're BCC. Nice shot there. Nice shot there by Rosensteel. Again, Amarell's Lady Bayhawks, they do have a lot of work to do, but they've been putting a lot of time in. Oh, that's Kiara Castro. Going to get it to fall, and she's fouled. .920 left to play. We're just getting underway here in the fourth quarter. From Bishop Connolly High School, here in Fall River, Kiara Castro, going to be a three-point play. gets it to go, 77-37, back to a 40-point lead. If you're BCC, you get to set a goal for yourself. You know, if you're Coach Amarillo, I think you say, hey, you know, they had a nice drive to the hole. Couldn't get it to go. That was Rosensteel. Again, if you're Coach Amarillo, I think you say, hey, let's set a goal for ourselves right now. Let's get it under 30. That shot right there is good by Farrah Beatty. Corner jumper is good. You know you're not going to win this game, but if you can try to cut into this lead a little bit, you know, have something to build off for the next game, have your girls build some confidence, feel good about themselves, it's always a good thing. So inbounding for the Bayhawks. Shannon Rosensteel. Oh, nice pass down inside. But number 31, Deborah Banks, couldn't connect down low. Lofty pass inside, no good. Number 25, Kia Pate, couldn't get it to go. Dean College is coming here with a lofty reputation. I spoke to Coach Aaron Morrell earlier before the game. He said Dean has an intimidating team. Going underneath the basket, putting it up, and not connecting his Ramos. Not sure what the call is here, but it's going to be Dean basketball. Going to be going their way. Just trying to get this clock squared away. All right. Just getting the clock situation taken care of. That's the discussion. Okay. So Dean walking the basketball up. Here's Kiara Castro. Jennifer Lang looking to get it inside. Kia Pate. Being triple team, loses it. Lang is open though, no good. Rebounded by the Bayhawks, Megan Parrish. Parrish pushing it the other way. Here's Misa Edwards, getting into the lane. Nice dump off, inside, no good. Banks couldn't get it to go. Good defense again by Dean. Good defensive game, great defensive game by the Bulldogs today. Yeah, they've been able to stymie the Bayhawks. Again, you're watching BCC Athletics, Bristol Community College. Because Bristol, BCC, Bristol Community College, changing the world learner by learner. Here's Jennifer Lang. Lang getting into the lane. Say that 20 times fast. Rebound by number 25, Kia Pate. Can't get it to go. All right, 30-second timeout here. Dean called the timeout. Coach Graham Smith calling a timeout for his Lady Bulldogs. All right, the BCC men's basketball team has started off the season 1-1. They lost their home opener this past Tuesday against Mass Bay in a thriller type of game. Went right down to the wire, and BCC lost by, I believe, 2 points in that first game. That home opener against Mass Bay, but those two will see each other again. They always play a thriller. BCC men's basketball team coached by Rob Del Lue. And BCC looking to be in the mix as they are every year under Coach Del Lue in his eighth season. So stay tuned for the men's basketball team as they look again to be a top team in Region 21. Long season lit for these Lady Bayhawks. Megan Parrish driving to her left, puts it up with her right, can't get it to go. Nice drive though, like to see her being aggressive. Definitely get some quickness. Here comes Kiara Castro being guarded by Parrish. Castro going up. Can't get it to go. There's a rebound. Foul. Kia Pate will step to the line for two. Coming in is number 20. Coming in for number 23, Farrah Beattie. Number 20, Tara Griffith, making her first appearance of the day. The center, 6'2" from Seattle, Washington. Went to Oak Hill High School. Free throw missed. Both free throws missed by number 25, Kia Pate. And here goes Misa Edwards. Edwards, down low to Rhodes Steele. Has Lady Bulldogs draped all over her. Couldn't get it to go. Going to be a foul away from the basketball. It's going to be on red number 25. It's going to be on Kia Pate. So the foul's on her. That's her third. 6:13 left to play in this one. Bristol trying to make a little run here, trying to make it respectable. Going to her left. Rodensteel puts it up. Bounces up. No good. That ball's rebounded by Tara Griffith. Now pushing it the other way. And out of bounds. You know, when you're building a program, as such as Aaron Morrell has already done a great job, when you're building a program like this, you know, these are some teaching points. Being down like this on your home court, you know, I think this can only build character. You can only, instill togetherness and, you know, and there's a lot to learn from a game like this. Here's Parrish stopping at the free throw line. Somehow ends up in Ramos' hands, but can't get it to fall. Kiara Castro comes away with it. David Cardoza here on the call, making it work. Doing the solo act tonight, but it's all good. Jennifer Lang. Now that finds inside. Back at Kia Pate's hands. She'll be fouled by Ramos. Tatiana Ramos will get the foul. Commit the foul. Kia Pate going to the line. Kia Pate again is a freshman forward, 5'9" from Taunton, Massachusetts, right down the road. Wow, that one bounces up and falls. Substitution made, number 24, Tayshia Alexandra, I think making her first appearance of the day. She's a 5'5" guard. 5'5" freshman from Quincy, Massachusetts. That free throw no good. 80-37. Here's Misa Edwards driving to the basket. And there's going to be a foul. It's probably going to be on the little one there, number four. It is going to be a number four, Jennifer Lang. Jennifer Lang is from Lakeville, Massachusetts, again down the road. Free throw made by Misa Edwards. Second one pops out. And it's going to be Dean basketball. Five minutes to play. Here's Lang. Jumper, no good. Put back, no good. Tip up. Dean basketball. Kiara Castro, nice dump in to Tara. But Tara couldn't get it to go. Here's Misa Edwards, looking to get into the lane. Does, but can't get it to fall. Nothing falling for BCC. Put back is good, though. Putback is good from Shannon Rosensteel. Again, quietly having a good game, having a decent game. 80-39. Jumper from the free throw line, no good. Had a good look at it, number 24, Tayshia Alexandra. Loose ball now. Nice hustle by Tara Griffith trying to get the basketball. Stepped out. Scores 80-39 with just 4 minutes left to play here. BCC has to make more moves towards the basket. Get it inside. There you go. Down inside. Hook. No good. Ramos with the miss. Had a good look at it. Good to see the Bayhawks still hustling, though, to the end. I don't think no lack of talent, I mean, no lack of hustle or effort. Bayhawks are definitely still engaged, definitely still playing hard to the last whistle. Just a little overmatched here today. A little overmatched here by the Bulldogs who have come in here and really asserted themselves late in the first quarter and have played a tremendous game. Nice look there by Rosensteel again. 80-41. Little garbage time now. Not gonna lie. Obviously, this one's in the books for the Bulldogs. They'll move on, and I'm sure they'll have a great season as this one rolls on. Got some good players. Here's Jennifer Lang over to number 24, Alexandra for three. No good. Rebounded by Parrish, looking up. Oh, she has an open Lady Bayhawk. Couldn't get it to go. Couldn't connect with her, but definitely had her open. Nice try to get it to number 20, Shannon Rosensteel. All right, so BCC. So Dean has a big lead, but it looks like they're calling all the timeouts, prolonging this thing. But it's 80-41, and yeah, that's it. 80-41. 2 minutes and 47 seconds left to play here from Bishop Conley High School. And we'll just take a timeout here as we'll keep it here, though. And while we're keeping it here, remember to listen to the Dirty Water Sports Hour on bccradio.org, 6:30 on Thursday. Listen to it on bccradio.org. You can go on there. Make it easier for you. Download the TuneIn Radio app. Also, you can watch the Dirty Water Sports Hour, too, as it will be broadcasted on this FR Media network, the station you're watching right now. Look for it on your dial. Look for it on your local Comcast, local listings there. Look for it on your guide. As we talk about all the best in Boston sports. Patriots in Seattle. Patriots and Seahawks this Sunday. Sunday Night Football. It's a rematch of Super Bowl 49. You know how that one turned out, but it's going to be a big one. Big mid-season test for the Patriots as they come out their bye week. Tom Brady and company getting back to work. Should be interesting. Getting ready for that. Happy Veterans Day. The night before Veterans Day, happy Veterans Day. Just want to give you all you veterans a shout out. A lot of respect. A lot of respect and a lot of love for what you do, keeping us safe. Every single day, every single second. It's amazing what you do. We love and respect you and have a lot of admiration for you. So shout out to all the veterans out there. Go out and get all your free stuff tomorrow. myself included. Go Navy. Stuff we talk about when it's 80-41. Lucy Cabral on the camera doing amazing camera work. Give yourself a pat on the back. And also the little stat girl from Dean. Great job. Misa Edwards with the basketball. Jump shot, no good. By Rosen Steele, rebounded by number 33, Adia Contractor, the freshman from Miami, Florida. That's not a bad upbringing, growing up in Miami. Living in Miami all year round, South Beach. And then you go to college in a little place called Bristol Community College. Change your life. Because Bristol, Bristol Bucks. Bristol Community College. It's definitely going to be a kind of a culture shock for her as she experiences this winter. It could be good. It could be bad. So far, it's so good here in the fall. As she misses both free throws. As she dons the number 33, Ala Larry Bird. Larry Bird would not be happy with those two free throws there, but we know it's gonna get better. Zoom in on Mr. Morell's shiny bald head. He has the same barber I do. 80-41. Loose ball. Again, I love Bristol Community College. I love BCC's enthusiasm and the way that they're staying engaged. And Aaron Morell has his team obviously playing hard all the way to the bitter end. Again, this is only early in the season. Driving to the hole, putting it up, and no good. Number 21, Amanda Moresi. Moresi stepping up to the line. And she gets that one to rattle home. I want to say everybody has scored today for Dean. Maybe except for Tara Griffith. And possibly Taisha Alexander, but I think everybody has had their spoon in the pot. Jumper by Lang is no good. Rebounded by Alexander. Love the ball move by Dean. Even here in the latter stages of the game. 3-point shot. Alexander had a look at it. Oh, nice save. Nice save attempt. Looked like she saved that one around her back. By Kia Pate. Gonna go back to BCC. That was pretty, though. I love the way BCC's rolling in to try to stop the clock, but I mean, down 40. Misa Edwards getting into the lane. It's gonna be a jump ball. Someone get their hand on it. Gonna stay right here for the Bayhawks. Trying to put a couple more points up on the board. Parrish out to the top to Ramos. Ramos driving to her right. Loses control of it. Dean always has their hands on the basketball. Got to admire that about them. It's going to be Dean basketball now. They're always forcing jump balls, forcing turnovers. Deflecting passes, causing havoc. They've been all over the place today. Down low, inside to number 25. Gets it to go. Kia Pate gets it to roll in. Dean with an outstanding offensive performance. Nice, down low to Ramos. No good. Good pass there by Edwards. Kia Pate going the other way, trying to pad her stats. She's going to the line. As Edwards comes from behind with a foul. quite a bit toasty here in the Bishop Conley gym. And it's not because of the action. First free throw is no good. .4 seconds left to go. These two teams giving it their all here. Driving to the hole. Kia Pate. Little too hard. Rebounded by Ramos. BCC looking to hold for the last shot here in the final quarter. But they're going to fall here to the Bulldogs. Zine Bulldogs coming in here and playing an outstanding game. Turnaround jump shot is good. Rosensteel, couple more points for her, but that's going to be it. The final score from Bishop Conley High School here in Fall River, Massachusetts, 83. Dean College Bulldogs, 83. The Bristol Community College Lady Bayhawks, 43. 40-point win for Dean. Dean College coming in here and spoiling this opener. They're spoiling this home game for the Bayhawks. So again, for Coach Amorell, he is looking to build something here. You know, build some sort of a, you know, build a tradition, trying to get it up to the men's level for BCC. All right, so we're wrapping it up here. Both coaches conversing again. 83-43 is the final. Again, Coach Amorell trying to build up this BCC program. BCC women's basketball is back. They didn't have field a team last year, but Coach Amorell was here recruiting. And believe me, he was here trying to get this thing to go, and he's got it going. He's got it going. He's 1-0 in Region 21, 1-4 now on the year. But if anybody can do it and bring this team back up to where it needs to be, it's that guy right there. So, again, 83-43 for Bishop Conley High School for David Cardoza. And on the camera, Lucy Cabral, the Cardoza-Cabral connection here today at Bishop Conley High School here in Fall River, Massachusetts. Again, the final score from Bishop Conley right next door to BCC, 83-43. The Bulldogs are winners. Good night, everybody.